Hi students, hope you all are doing good. So today we'll continue with the chapter electric potential and capacitance. Okay, so last class, if you remember, using this definition of potential at a point, so potential at a point due to some source charge, the definition is the work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to that point against the field. Okay, against the field of which charge? Source charge. So that definition we remember. So the formula is minus integral E dr, okay, from infinity to that point. Minus sign here signifies that you are doing work against the field, okay, and this is the work done per unit charge. See, actually work done is force into displacement, yes or no? But in order to define potential, you need to bring what kind of charge? Point charge, sorry, unit charge. So if you bring unit charge, then what will be force equals to on the unit charge? Q into E. But if Q is unit charge, then you will write 1 here. So instead of force, you can write E also when you write definition of potential. Okay. So using this formula, what we can do is, if you know the formula for electric field due to some source charge, you can find potential due to the source charge. Okay. So that is what we have done for last class for shell of charge, right? So let me remind you the formula quickly. So if you have a shell of charge uniformly, okay, distributed like this, and if I say the total charge is capital Q and the radius is capital R, okay, slightly not visible, right? Yeah, okay, so total charge is capital Q, radius is capital R. Then outside, if you want potential, outside means at some point here, which is how far from the center, let us say small r. Then potential outside is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught total charge of the shell divided by distance from the center of the shell to the point where you want potential, and that point is also called observation point. Okay, so this is the definition for the formula for potential due to a shell of charge outside the shell. On the surface, if I ask surface here, okay, then you have to write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q by capital R, because when this point is here, your small r will become capital R. Then we found one very interesting thing, and that is potential inside at any point is constant, and it is equal to same as on the surface, which is equal to this. Okay students, so this is something, you know, very very important to remember, because this is something, you know, we don't feel like it will be like this, but it is like this. The reason is very simple. Inside, electric field is zero, and electric field, if you remember, is minus dv by dr, remember or not? So if electric field is zero, potential should be constant. Okay, so this is for shell of charge. Now they may sometimes ask you to draw a graph of potential versus distance. So let us say on y axis I will plot potential, on x axis I will plot distance from the center, and let us say this is your radius of the shell. So here small r, this coordinate is less than capital R, right? Here small r is greater than capital R. So when you are here, you are inside the shell. When you are here, you are outside the shell. Now inside the shell, what is the potential? Inside the shell, the potential is constant. So since the y coordinate is constant, graph should be like this, right? I hope all of you know, when y coordinate is constant, the graph should be parallel to x axis. And then once you go outside, it is inversely proportional to distance from the center, right? So outside, it will be inversely proportional. Inversely proportional means as r your increases, potential will decrease. So this is how potential due to a shell looks like when you plot the graph. Don't confuse with electric field, students. Electric field, if you remember, for same shell of charge, electric field, if you remember, inside electric field was zero, then suddenly it jumps and then it becomes like this, right? So this is electric field versus distance graph. This is potential versus distance graph. For what kind of charge? Shell of charge. Let us now see, we did for solid sphere of charge. What kind of charge? Solid sphere of charge, meaning the charge is now not only on the outer surface, but it is everywhere inside the sphere. So then I discussed about solid sphere of charge. Right now I will not mention that it should be non-conducting actually. Let me mention it, no problem. Non-conducting. It should be non-conducting. If it is conducting, no students, then all the charge will go on the outer surface. That we will discuss later after this few numerical exercise we have to do conductors. So we will come to that later. So let us imagine I have a sphere of charge, but this time the charge is everywhere inside, uniformly distributed. Okay, then now you have to be careful. If you want, this is the total charge is Q, let's say, radius is capital R. Okay, now if you are outside at some point here, distance from the center is smaller, then outside the formula was same as shell only. It was 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. On the surface, it will be same as shell, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q by capital R, where capital R is the radius of the sphere. Now, when you are inside, then we did one lengthy derivation. The derivation is not useful for entrance exam, but you must remember the formula. And since I do derivation, so that, you know, if you see the derivation, if you see how it comes, then it is easy to remember. Yes or no? So the formula is Q by 8 pi epsilon naught, there was capital R. Okay, I'll check this formula, don't worry. Okay, 1 minus R squared by R squared. Was it 1 or 3 here? Let me check. Okay, I think it was 3. Now, how will I check whether I'm right or wrong? When small r becomes capital R, meaning when small r, this is your small r, no? So when small r becomes capital R, I should get this formula, right? This is for outside. This is for R greater than capital R. Outside means your distance from the center should be greater than the radius. No, this is for R less than capital R. This is for R equal to capital R. So if I put R equal to capital R here, I should get this. Let us check. If I put small r equal to capital R here, R square by R square will be 1, 3 minus 1 will be 2, 2 divided by 8 will be 4, so I will get this answer. Okay, it is very nice. At the center, if I ask, at the center, for a solid sphere, okay, not shell. For a shell of charge, what I told, potential everywhere inside is constant and it is same as on the surface. Please remember that. So for shell we know, for solid sphere, center means what will happen? Small r will be equal to zero, no students? Because small r is distance from the center wherever you want potential. So if you want potential at the center, your small r will be zero. Put small r zero, you will get 3q by 8 pi epsilon naught r. And this you can write 3 by 2 times potential on the surface. Okay. So these are the results which you should remember for your entrance exams. Now let us see how the potential, okay, due to this sphere changes with distance from the center in a graph. Okay, so they may ask you sometimes graph also in entrance exams. So this is potential and this is distance from the center. So this point means your distance from the center is zero, no, origin, right? So this represents the center of the sphere. Somewhere here is your radius, and here you are inside, R is less than capital R. Here you are outside, R is greater than capital R. Now look carefully. Potential at the center, which means here, potential at this point is 3 by 2 times on the surface. But the potential on the center will be more. Yes or no? 3 by 2 means 1.5. So if this is 2, 1.5 into 2 will be, this will be 3. So this will be more than this. Understood or not? So at R equal to 0, potential at the center is more than on the surface. So this is on the surface. Okay, so on the surface, if I write Vs, at the center it will be 3 by 2 times Vs. Okay, then outside it will be inversely proportional to R. Outside it is inversely proportional to R. So as you go from center to the surface, right, your potential should decrease, because at center potential is more than surface. Will it decrease linearly? No, because there is R square, so it will be quadratic kind of graph, right? Square is there, whenever square is there, the graph will be quadratic. So it will look like this, parabolic type, like this, and then outside it will decrease like this. Okay, students, so this is how the, don't draw straight line, okay? Then it will be wrong. So this is potential versus distance. What about electric field, if you remember? Electric field was easy, right? So electric field versus distance, if you remember, inside it was proportional. So graph was like this. Outside it was inversely proportional to R square. So this we have done already. Please check the video. So be careful whether they are asking graph of potential versus distance or electric field versus distance. That you please check first, okay, before deciding. So after knowing potential due to shell of charge and solid sphere of charge, non-conducting, let us now see potential due to line charge, okay. So if you remember, if there is a line charge, then at a distance r, electric field was how much, if you remember? 1 by 4, it was lambda divided by 2 pi epsilon naught r. Okay, so see, even I tend to think 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. That formula comes first in your mind, no? But you have to be careful. That is for point charge or spherical charge, that also outside. For line charge, electric field at a distance r is lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught r. And direction was away if it is positive charge. So using this, we will try to find potential. But I will only calculate potential difference between two points. I will not be able to calculate potential at a point. I will be able to calculate potential difference. Okay, that is, think of it. Why we cannot calculate potential at a point using whatever we have done till now. So till now, if you remember, for shell of charge, solid sphere of charge, I was able to calculate potential also by taking where potential is zero. Which point I have taken potential as zero? Infinity. Infinity was chosen as reference, right? So in case of line charge, you will see that you cannot choose infinity as reference. And I want you to think why it is like that. So first you see the derivation. So imagine this is your line charge. Okay, let me take two points A and B. Okay, so let us say this distance from the line charge is RA and this distance is RB from the line charge. Okay, now potential difference. Okay, potential difference as I go from B to A, because field is like this, no? I have to go against the field. So B to A. Okay, let me do this way otherwise. Let me write this as B, this as A. Then this is your RB, this is your R. Okay, I am just doing like this so that it matches with our old formula. It doesn't matter, students. You can write A here, B here, what is there, right? Okay, so I will go like this from A to B. So potential difference VB minus VA. What was the definition? Minus E dr. E was saying I am moving the charge against the field. Remember, no, from initial point is RA. Right, your initial distance is RA and final is RB. Okay, so this we have to calculate. Okay, now let us, we know the electric field due to line charge at some distance R, we know the formula, so let us substitute. So VB minus VA will be minus RA RB. Substitute this E here. So lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught R dr. Constants you can take outside. So VB minus VA will be minus lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught. What it will be left? Integral of 1 by R dr from RA to RB. Okay, students, now listen carefully. Integral of 1 by x dx will be log x. That is because differentiation of log x is 1 by x. So integration and differentiation are reverse process. So differentiation of log x is 1 by x, integration of 1 by x, 1 by x dx is log x. Okay, Suresh sir will be mentioning this later, don't worry. Usually he will say there should be a constant of integration also, some constant, but I'm not interested, okay, because I'm going to put limits. So just remember the formula, that much is enough. Okay, so here if I substitute the formula, what will be the integration of 1 by x dx? Log x, no? So let me put directly the formula here. So it will be log r base e. Upper limit is rb, lower limit is ra. Then what is the next step? Put the limits. So minus lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught. Put limits. Put upper limit first. Log of rb base e minus log of ra base e. Then you know one formula, right? Log a minus log b. That will be what? Log a by b. So this will be, let me write it here. So potential difference between b and a, points b and a, in the electric field of line charge, remember, okay, line charge will be how much? Minus lambda by, let me write this as plus, okay. If I write this as plus, then how it will look? This will come here, this will go there, no? So it will be log Ra minus log Rb minus log Rb base e. So I did this because I wanted this to be positive. Okay, it is nice to write positive formula, no? In life you should be positive, not negative, right? So let us see now what will happen. So now let us use the formula. Vb minus Va will be lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught. This I can finally write log base e Ra by Rb. Okay, so this formula, please try to remember. It will be very useful for your entrance exams. Okay. So I hope all everything is clear here. So this is the potential difference. Okay. So now look carefully. Let us check. Okay, whether the sign came correctly or not. How will be electric field for line charge? Like this. No, for in this plane, it will be away. So it is going this way. It means this should be what potential? Higher potential. Already we know electric field is from higher potential to lower potential. So Vb is greater than Va. So this should be positive. Let us check whether it is positive or not. Here we can check. Ra is more, Rb is less, right? So this is more, this is less. So we did it correctly. So by chance, if you do some mistake with the sign also, don't worry. Just calculate the difference first. Magnitude you calculate first. Then sign you can decide from here, I told already, right? So that is a smart thing which I have discussed with all of you. Okay? So line charge is done. Then we will do for sheet of charge. So these are the potential difference for line charge. Now let us see potential due to sheet of charge. Sheet of charge. So imagine I have a sheet of charge like this. For sheet of charge, it will be very, very easy. Why it will be very easy? Because for sheet of charge, electric field is uniform. You remember, right? And how much is the formula? Sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Remember or not sheet of charge? So since electric field is uniform, if you take two points A here and B here, okay, then directly you can write potential difference will be equal to E into this distance. Remember, no? The formula I did yesterday also, E d cos theta. So E is here, my B is also here. Modulus I'm calculating, so I don't care about minus sign. So EB, so it will be sigma by 2 epsilon naught D. So this is the potential difference between A and B. Here let me write between A and B. Okay, then if you want to see the sign, if they want VA minus VB, it should be positive because electric field is going from higher potential to lower potential. So if you want VA minus VB, it should be sigma by 2 epsilon naught into distance between the two points. And if you want VB minus VA, it will be minus of this. Right? Same thing. So for sheet of charge, it is very easy. So in case of line charge and sheet of charge, we were able to calculate only the potential difference. Okay? And that is because in these two cases, it will be meaningless to take infinity as reference. Okay, students, so think about it and remember whatever has been done till now. Now we will solve some numerical problems from our material. Okay, not numerical problems, that is over. So we will have to start the session 2. So in session 2 I will do the review exercise also. Okay, review exercise. Usually I don't do review exercise mostly. That is because while explaining, you know, many things, the review exercise will be covered and you have to try to do it yourself. But this session I would like to do the review exercise because it will be very useful for doing the further topics. Okay, so let us see first question 2.2. Let V be the potential at a point. So at some point P, they are saying V is the potential. Let us remember what is the meaning of this. This is the work done to bring 1 coulomb charge from infinity to this point, from reference to this point, which means there must be some source charge somewhere. Without source charge, you cannot have potential. For point charge, for line charge, for sheet of charge, we have done potential, right? So potential, listen carefully, potential at this point is given as V. So they are asking what would be the work done to bring a charge Q. So you are bringing a charge Q from infinity to this point. Very simple, this is work done to bring 1 coulomb charge. So work done to bring Q coulomb charge will be what? Q into V, right? So this is work done to bring 1 coulomb charge. So work done to bring 2 coulomb charge will be 2 into V. Work done to bring Q coulomb charge will be Q into V. Understanding or not? Okay. So this will be like, you know, some 10 joules per coulomb. So that is the work done per unit charge, per coulomb. Per coulomb, you have to do this much work. So for 2 coulombs, you have to do, multiply these two, what will you get? 20 joules like that. All of you understood, right? And if you remember, that is nothing but potential energy also. Potential energy of the charge at this point. Okay. Let us see now question number 2. If a body moves, listen carefully, if a body moves without any external forces. So this time they are saying no external forces. So Pankaj sir is not going to move the charge. There is no external forces. In a conservative field here could be electric field, such that the change in potential energy delta U is negative. What can you say about its kinetic energy? Very simple. Let us go back to work done by all the forces you know is delta K. Now work done by all the forces could be work done by electric field plus work done by external force. Usually the external force I told is Pankaj sir's force. An electric field force would be some due to some source charge. Here they say there is no external force. And if you remember, work done by electric field is always minus of change in potential energy. Yes or no? Understanding or not? So this is something very useful to remember. If external forces are not there, only conservative forces are there, like electric field, like electrostatic force, or like gravitational force, or like spring force. All these three are conservative forces. So in case of conservative forces, you can write this result. Minus of change in potential energy is plus of change in kinetic energy. You all know these students already. Let me explain. See, what is delta U? Final potential energy U2 minus initial. And what is delta K? Final kinetic energy minus initial. Minus you multiply, this will become plus. Something nice will come. Just keep watching. Then you bring minus K1 this side. And then take minus U2 that side. Oho, what is this? You remember? What is this kinetic energy plus potential energy? This is your initial mechanical energy. And this is your final mechanical energy. So if there are no external forces, then your mechanical energy is conserved. Matlab, total mechanical energy at some position should be equal to total mechanical energy at some other position. Okay, so that's why we say usually, you know, when you drop a ball, when you drop, there is no other, I am not taking it down, no, I am just dropping it. So which forces are acting on the ball? Only gravity, which is conservative force like electric field. So in that case, what do we say? When kinetic energy increases, potential energy decreases, because the total should remain constant. If one number increases, other number should, if one number increases, other number should decrease, because total should be constant. Okay, so here, since external forces are not there, so work done by external forces will be zero. Therefore, delta U or delta K will be minus of delta U. Now in the question, they are told delta U is negative, then delta K will be what? Positive. Okay, that means kinetic energy will increase, because change is positive, right? If you have 2 rupees and now you have 10 rupees, what is the change? Plus 8, 10 minus 2. So the money has increased. So whenever the change in a quantity is positive, it means the quantity is increasing. So you can write kinetic energy increases if potential energy decreases, or if change in potential energy is negative, then it means potential energy is decreasing. So change in kinetic energy will be positive. That means kinetic energy is increasing. Third question you see. A system of particles at rest, okay, has potential energy 10 joules. The configuration of the system, configuration means the position of the particles, is changed, they are saying. Without changing the kinetic energy. Without changing the kinetic energy means probably it is something like this. Imagine this is a system. Imagine this is a system, duster and pen. This is a system, right, of two particles or two objects. So right now this is the position and they have some potential energy. Then I slowly change the position. But I did slowly. So kinetic energy did not change. Okay. So in the third question, they are saying, Initial potential energy is 10 joules of system. Then some forces are acting, because of which the positions have changed. And if position changes, potential energy will change. Final potential energy, they are saying, is 15 joules of system. Question is, how much work is done by the external agency? So somebody was moving, right? So in case of, like, for this duster, if you want this to move slowly, then you have to apply force against gravity. No, because moving slowly means, again and again I keep telling you, moving slowly means no acceleration. So the total force according to Newton's second law should be zero. If acceleration is zero, net force should be zero. So you should always balance gravity in this case. In this case, whatever forces, electrostatic forces are acting between the charges, that has to be balanced by external forces. So work done by external force, directly you can write delta U, because here there is no change in kinetic energy, since kinetic energy does not change. So this will be 15 minus 10 equal to 5 joules. So try to remember all these small things which I have covered in the review exercise 2.2. So the first topic now we have to discuss is potential energy, already we have discussed, but now we will discuss for system of charges. Potential energy of system of charges. So what is the meaning of this? Listen carefully. Imagine you have some system of charges. So this is your system. Due to their positions, they will be having some potential energy right now. What is that potential energy, or how will you calculate that potential energy? Very simple. What you do, take all of them to infinity, because that is where we have chosen the reference. So take all of them to infinity. Then you bring first this charge. So take all of them to infinity. Now bring Q1 from infinity to its position. See how much work you did, W1. Uniformly you have to bring, slowly you have to bring. Then you bring Q2 from infinity to its position. How much work you did, W2. Okay, then you bring Q3 from infinity to its position. how much work you did, W3. Add all of them. That is the potential energy of the system. Very simple, right? So what is potential energy of the system? How will you define? It is the work done to bring the charges from infinity to their respective positions in the system. In bracket, you can mention without acceleration. Matlab slowly. So I hope all of you understood the definition. You can see the EPL definition is mentioned here. Okay, I will not be writing. It will take more time. Okay. So let me mention again. What is potential energy of a system of charges? Work done to bring the charges from infinity to their respective positions in the system. Okay. Against the whatever electrostatic forces are acting while bringing the charge. So now let us calculate the first three-mark derivation. Potential energy of a two-point charges. Or let me write nicely, potential energy of a system having two-point charges. So only two-point charges, imagine. Okay, so imagine here is Q1 and here is Q2. At some distance r. Let us say this point is A, let us say this point is B, and I want to know potential energy of this system. So how will I calculate? So as I told you, the definition is work done to bring these charges from infinity to their respective positions without any acceleration. So let us take both of them to infinity now. Points will be there, na? Points A and B will be there only, charges are not there. So both the charges are where now? Infinity. Now you bring the first charge. Okay. So to bring charge Q1 from infinity to point A, work done will be how much? What is the work done to bring a charge Q from infinity to this point? Let us say here potential is V. Then work done will be what? Q into V. Q is the charge which you are bringing. What charge you are bringing? Q1. Should be Q1 into V. Usually this is how we write. No, first question today only we have discussed. But students, potential will be here only if there is some source charge. So right now there is no source charge, right? Yes or no? Right now in this question, right now there are no source charges. So when you bring Q1, the first charge, from infinity to this point, you don't do any work. How much work you do? Zero. It is like saying, suppose Earth is not there. Suppose Earth is not there. How much work will be done to move this duster from here to here, let's say? How much work will be done if Earth is not there? No work will be done. Why will you do work? If you do slightly pull like that, it will go uniformly itself only. Because Newton's first law say a body in motion will continue to be in motion. Yes or no, students? So please understand, right now there is no source charge anyway. So potential here will be zero. Potential here right now will be zero. So when you bring Q1, the first charge, from infinity to this point, no work will be done. Why no work will be done? Because there is no potential only at any point. There is no source charge against whom you have to do work. Understanding all of you? Okay. So to bring Q1 from infinity to this position, okay, how much work you did? Zero. Free of cost. It was free. Okay. Now, to bring charge Q2 from infinity to point B. Now, will you do work? Yes. Now you will do work, because now Q1 is already sitting here. So Q1 will produce some potential here. Yes or no? So it will be how much now work done? The charge which you are bringing, what charge you are bringing? Q2 into whatever potential is present at this point. Potential at B. Correct? No? Okay. Now, come to this side. What is potential at B? Which is the source charge now? Now this is the source charge, because Q1 is already, you have already brought Q1, no? So Q1 will produce some potential here. How much it will be? Already we know for point charge formula, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught source charge divided by distance r. So therefore, this work done will be how much? substitute this potential here, so it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r. Understanding? Okay, clear? No, so just substitute this potential here. So in the numerator you will have q2 also, q1 also. I hope everyone is clear, students. See, at some point if there is potential V, then it means some source charge is there which is producing the potential. Just now we have discussed, no, for point charge, what is the potential at some distance? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q, which is the source charge, divided by the distance between source charge and the point. Similarly, we did for shell of charge, yes or no, for solid sphere of charge, line charge also we did today, sheet of charge also we did. So we need some source charge to have potential. Initially, I took both the charges to infinity. So at those points, there were no charges. So to bring the first charge, you will do zero work. Why? Because there is no potential. Understanding or not? So to bring Q charge, if there is already some potential, then to bring Q charge. See, understand, to bring Q charge, I am saying. Who is producing this potential? Source charge. To bring Q charge against the force of the source charge, how much work you do? Q into V. Just now we have discussed. But if potential is zero, then the work done also will be zero. Okay, students? Fine. From infinity to that point. So I hope all of you understood this part. So once you bring Q1, now you, when you will bring Q2 from infinity to this point, you will have to do some work. We are not going to do all integration and all, students. Why will we do? This formula we have already derived. No, using integration only we have derived. First video of this second chapter, you see. This formula was derived. Very important derivation. 5 marks it will come. So already we have done the derivation using integration. So why will we keep doing it again and again? So we will just remember that this is the potential at point B due to this charge. Then when you bring the other charge, Q2, this much work you have to do. And therefore, the potential energy of this system, potential energy of the system will be equal to how much? Work done to bring the first charge plus work done to bring the second charge. So potential energy will be, this is 0, right? And this is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r. So I hope all of you understood. Very simple derivation, so don't lose the 3 marks. Okay, sometimes they will say potential energy of a system, this is the one they usually ask. But let us try to do more, having 3 point charges. So imagine I have one charge here q1, one charge here q2, one charge here q3. Okay, and this distance is, let's say, r12, this distance is r23, and this distance is r13. Or if you want some other symbol, you can write your wish. So this is the, I want potential energy of this system now. So what I should do? Take both of them, take not both of them, all three of them to infinity. Then you bring the charge Q1. What work will you do to bring charge Q1? Zero. Yes or no? Because right now there are no source charges. So potential here is zero. So if potential here is zero, to work to bring any charge Q, work done will be Q into V, but V here is zero. So work done will be zero. So I can bring Q1 free of cost without spending any energy. Now let me bring second charge Q2 here. When I bring the second charge, first charge is already sitting here, so that will act like your source charge. So work done will be, already I told you, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by this distance, right? r12. Now you have to bring q3. Now be careful. When you bring q3, when you will bring q3, this is also there, this is also there. So both of them will produce potential here. So it will be how much? Q3 into potential at C. And potential at C, who will produce these two source charge? How much would be the potential? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 divided by this distance plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 Q2 divided by this distance, right? Distance between source charge and observation point. So this is the point where I first calculate the potential. Because potential means work done to bring 1 coulomb charge. So work done to bring Q3 coulomb charge. This is work done to bring 1 coulomb charge. So work done to bring Q coulomb charge will be Q into V. Okay? Here I wrote VC because it is potential at C. Who will produce potential at C? This source charge and this source charge. So this distance is R2. Then if you multiply this with this, this with this, finally you will get, let me just rub here. Please write down, okay, students. If you don't write, it is useless, I'm telling you. So formula will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 Q3 divided by R2 3 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q3 or Q3 Q1, same thing, by R1 3. So now what will be the potential energy of the system of these three charges? Add this work done, this work done, this work done. So it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by this distance plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q3 by R1 3 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 Q3 by R2 3. So this will be the potential energy of this three charge system. Again, students, it will be difficult to, you know, keep calculating this way. No, first find, take all of them to infinity, then bring first charge, what is the work done, find, then bring second charge, see what is the work done. It will be difficult to do this, especially while doing, you know, numericals or entrance exam questions. So then the trick is, the easy way is this. Already you know, if I give you a pair of charges, at some distance r, what is the potential energy? Now you know, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r. Yes or no, student? This one we have done in the beginning today. So since we know this, what you do is, when they give you a system of charges more than two, then first find how many pairs are there. And then for each pair, you write this formula, that will be the total potential energy. So for this pair, you write potential energy, one pair. Then for this pair, you write. Then for this pair, you write. So three pairs are there. And for each pair, you use this formula. You can see here, first pair, second pair, and this is your third pair. Okay. So like that, we can easily find potential energy of multiple point charges of a system. Okay, so now let me give you some simple problems so that whatever we have learned now will be, you know, remembered. Okay, things will be remembered once you practice using it, once you do application of whatever you have learned. So let us do some simple problems for entrance. Suppose I give you a square. Triangle I will not give because I did already. So I give you a square. Side is, let's say, A. Here Q, here Q, here Q, here Q. I want potential energy of the system. So pause the video and try to solve yourself first. Okay, first you count how many pairs are there. Like this, how many pairs will be there? See, 1 pair, 2 pair, 3 pair, 4 pair. Then you will find this pair, 5 pair, then 6th pair. So totally there are 6 pairs. So potential energy of the system will be like this. How many pairs are there? Like this, there are 4 pairs. Yes or no? Like this means having same charge and same distance. There are 4 pairs. So it will be 4 into, right, potential energy of this pair, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by Q1, Q2 are both Q divided by this distance. Why 4? Because there are 4 pairs. Now, like this, how many pairs are there? Like this, there are 2 pairs. Yes or no, students? This pair and this pair. So it will be 2 times potential energy of one pair. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q cube divided by this diagonal distance we have to use. Diagonal distance, okay, this distance. So this distance will be how much from Pythagoras theorem? Root 2a. Okay, so I can write, sorry, this part is, so will be root 2a. So this will be the potential energy of the system of square. I will give you one homework. Try, it will be nice exercise for your brain. Next video I will do it anyways, but you try, okay? So I will give you a cube. And at each corner, I will put charge Q. At each corner, I will put charge Q. Q, Q everywhere, okay? And the side of the cube is A. So I want potential energy of the system. So try it out. Count how many pairs will be there, okay? So there will be three kinds of pairs. I am not saying there are three pairs. Three kinds of pairs. So there will be one pair with distance A. Yes or no? With this distance A. One pair with distance, this distance, root 2A. So there will be some pairs having distance root 2A. And then there will be some pairs having, look carefully, this distance also. This distance also, right? This is also one pair, no? So to find this distance, how will, what will you do? First find this distance. So you know this is 90 degree, no? So if this is A, this is A, this diagonal will be root 2A. Correct, students? Root 2. Is it visible? Root 2A. Now this is root 2A, this is A. So this diagonal will be root of root 2A square plus A square. That will be root 3A. So I have given you the distance as a hint. Now you just count how many pairs are there and then do the calculation. Okay? Fine. So now we will do potential energy for two point charges but with some external field. Okay, that is also there in the syllabus, board syllabus. So what we did before was potential energy of two point charges, right? And the formula is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r, you say, don't say r square, that will be force. So potential energy of two point charges in presence of external electric field. Okay, so in presence of external electric field. What we did before was in the absence of external electric field, we only considered two point charges and their electric field, of course, we have considered, but we are not considered, we did not consider other source charges besides those two point charges. Now what I am saying is this, I am saying there is some source charge somewhere. I don't care about what kind of source charge it is, ring of charge, shell of charge. By the way, I did not do potential due to ring. So I will do it in some other, sometime later, okay? Okay, coming back to this topic, I have some source charge you think somewhere and you know that source charge will have electric field. So let us just assume for simplicity electric field is E, uniform or something you assume. Now, because there is electric field at every point, there will be some potential now. These are points, okay? I have not put any charge. So what is this two, what is this dots represent? Points, okay, A and B. And what is VA and VB? Potentials at A and B due to the this electric field, or you can say due to the source charge, like we did no shell of charge, outside we calculated potential, right? Think like that. Think somewhere there is source charge, but what kind of source charge, I don't care. I'm just saying there is an external electric field already present in the space. So already there is an external electric field, because of which at every point there will be some potential. So VA and VB represents, VA is potential at A, VB is potential at B due to the external field. due to the external electric field. Think like that. Now, I want to know potential energy of two point charges kept at these points. So, I am going to put Q1 here, Q2 here. So, I want to now know what is the potential energy of this system. So, what will we do? Take both of them to infinity. First, you take both of them to infinity. Now, students, be careful, okay? Now, tell me work done to bring Q1. This is work done to bring Q1. Now, see, be careful. There is already potential here. And what is the meaning of potential? Work done to bring 1 coulomb charge. So, now you are bringing Q1 coulomb charge from infinity to this point, remember. I am going to keep Q1 at this point. So, what work will I do? Q1 into potential here. Potential here I have written VA. Okay, before it was 0, if you remember. Before this was 0. That is because before there was nothing here. Only two charges were there and one of the charge was at infinity. First charge I was bringing from infinity to that point, right? No? Okay. But now already there is an external electric field. And what is this VA? Potential at point A, which is due to some source charge somewhere which we are not interested to know right now. We are just interested to find potential energy of two point charges in the presence of external electric field. So, because of the external electric field, at every point, there will be some potential already present. So, VA is potential, which means work done to bring 1 coulomb charge. So, work done to bring Q1 coulomb charge will be Q1 into V. V at which point? A. So, I wrote Q1 here, this much work I did. Okay. Now, I will bring Q2. So, work done to bring Q2. Okay, from infinity, that you should know, from infinity to A. Again, some part is going that side. From infinity to A. And here, from infinity to B, I am going to bring the charge, Q2. So, W2, how much work will I do? Now, at this point, there is already potential VB and also there will be potential due to this charge. How much it will be? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. This Q1 divided by this R. So, let's say this distance is R. So, it will be Q2 into potential due to this charge. How much it was? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 by R. This was the one that we did already. Now, you will also have to write Q2 into VB. What is VB? Potential here due to the external field. Understanding or not? Okay. So, therefore, potential energy of the system of these two point charges, okay, Q1, Q2, will be how much now? Q1 into VA, this work done, plus this work done. Q2 into VB, plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q1, Q2 by R. Okay, students, so be careful about this. By the way, if external electric field is not there, and that is only the one they ask in exam, so, if in the absence of external electric field, if they say absence, then this field will not be there. These potentials will not be there. So, this will be 0, this will be 0. You will get your old result. This is our old result, right? Yes or no? We did just a few minutes back. Okay. Fine, students. So, having done so many things, now we will do some numericals. Okay. I enjoy doing numericals and I want all my students also to have fun when we do numericals, because that is very scoring, number one, and number two, you are applying whatever you have learned. So, that should be very, very enjoyable. Okay. So, before we start numericals, there are two kinds of numericals for this session. Let me explain. First kind of numerical is, they will tell you some source charges are present. So, these are some source charges. I don't know how many of them. Let me say 4 source charges. Then they will say 2 points they will take. Any 2 points anywhere. So, A and B are points. Then they will ask, what is the work done to move a charge Q0? So, this is another charge. Okay, this is not your source charges. Source charges are fixed charges. So, this is the charge which we are moving. V from one point to another point, and they will ask you to calculate work done. Okay, let us say this is B, this is A. So work done to move Q naught from A to B by some external agency. Okay, what will be the work done? The charge which you are moving into potential at B minus potential at A. This formula already you know. Then what? So before calculating this right side, what you should do? Calculate the potentials at A and B because of these source charges. So each one of them will produce some potential here. If it is point charge, you know the formula. If it is spherical charge also, you know the formula now. So at every point, there will be some, forget about this charge now. What you do? Calculate potential here first, VA. Calculate potential here, VB, due to this source charge. Then use this definition, this formula to find work done to move another charge. So this is one type of problem which they ask. Okay, so make a note. Second type of problem that they usually ask in this session, in these concepts which we have covered till now, is they will give you some system of charges. Some system of charges. Then they will change the configuration. They have changed the configuration. So you can see that, okay, let me bring Q2 here. So you can see the positions, the relative positions have changed, which means potential energy of the system will change. They will ask, what is the work done to change the configuration from here to here? Not work done to bring a charge from one point to another point. So this is work done to bring some charge Q0 from A to B. This is one type of problem. Another type is they will give you some system and they will change the system. They will ask, what is the work done in this process? So here what you do is you just calculate the initial potential energy, which we know, right? Just now I have taught you. So find initial potential energy of the system, then find final potential energy of the system, and the work done by the external force to change the system. Slowly, they will usually not mention, but you have to remember, it is done slowly only. So if you change the system from here to here, work done will be delta U. Delta U matlab U final minus U initial. Okay, students, so these are the two kinds of problems which we should remember, and let us apply. So numerical exercise 2.2, question number 1. It says, a charge of 8 millicoulomb is located at the origin. So imagine this is your x axis and this is your y axis. And at the origin, there is a charge 8 millicoulomb located. That means it is very clear this is your source charge because it is located, it is at rest at this point. Okay. Calculate the work done in taking a small charge of minus 2 nanocoulomb. So they are bringing a charge of minus 2 nanocoulomb from a point P, which is coordinate is 0, 0, 3 cm. 0, 0, 3 cm means z axis, no? So let me try to make this one as z axis, okay? Otherwise, z will be here. So if I write here x, here y, z will be here, no? So it will be difficult for me to show. So let me write z here. So, and I'll see what is this called, this axis. So, Z coordinate, let me write here. And they said 0, 0, 3 centimeters. So, it will be somewhere here. Coordinate is 0, 0, 3 centimeters. So, this much is your Z coordinate from origin. Okay. This is your point P. Other one is 0, 4, 0 centimeters. So, this is your Y, let's say. So, 0, 4, 0 will be somewhere here, right? So this is your which point Q. This is 0, 4 centimeter 0. So this is your Y. If see, X coordinate and Z coordinate is 0. So where will be the point? On Y axis. And another point is 0, 6, 9. So Y is 6, Z is 9. So somewhere here. This is your R. 0, 6 centimeter, 9 centimeter. So we have to calculate work done to take a charge the charge which we are moving, let me call it Q naught, is minus 2 nanocoulomb. Source charge, let me write Q. Okay, so this is my source charge. Source charge. Okay, so we have to calculate work done in bringing a taking a small charge minus 2 nanocoulomb from where to where? Point P to point Q. So from here to here, they are saying via point R. Via point R means you have to go from here to here through this. So first you go like this, then you go like this. Like that they are saying. Now listen, there's no need to do such a long problem. Make it simple. Since electrostatic force is what kind of force? Conservative force. Conservative force. It means work done from P to R to Q will be same as work done from P to Q. Why? Because it does not depend on the path. It only depends on initial position and final position. That is the beauty of conservative forces. So instead of doing this lengthy problem, we will do this problem, easy problem. So work done from P to R to Q will be same as work done from P to Q. And that will be what formula? What charge we are moving? Q naught. So the charge which we are moving into potential difference, Vq minus Vp. This you write very carefully, okay students? When it was A to B, this was Vb minus Va. Don't forget. So we have to find potential due to the source charge. This is the not the source charge, okay? This is the one which we are bringing. So this is your source charge. So let us calculate potential at P. What is the formula? It is a what kind of source charge? Point. So apply the formula point charge. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Source charge is Q divided by distance between. Let us say this is O. O to P. So this is your R. This is your R, no? Which we used to write distance between source charge and observation point. Because I am writing potential at P first. So that will be 9 into 10 power 9. Source charge is 8 millicoulomb, 8 into 10 power minus 3, milli means 10 to the power minus 3 divided by R in centimeters. So it will be how much? 3 into 10 power minus 2 meter. So convert everything into SI units. So it will be 3s are 9, it will be 3 8s are 24 into minus 2 will go up plus 2, plus 2 minus 3 minus 1. Minus 1 plus 9 plus 8. So 10 to the power plus 8 volt. So that is the potential at P. Let us now calculate potential at Q. At Q. This is at P. Due to, there is only one source charge. Okay. So at Q, what will be potential at Q? This is the source charge. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Source charge divided by distance between source charge and observation point, which is your Q now. Okay students, I want potential at Q, remember. So this is the point. So this distance we have to write OQ. So that will be 9 into 10 to the power 9. Q is 8 into 10 power minus 3. And this is 4 centimeter. Na? So 10 power minus 2. So 4 2s are 8. Right students, so this will be 9 2s are 18 into 10 power 8 volt. Okay. So look carefully what we have done. We found potential at point P due to the source charge. Then we found potential at Q due to the source charge. Once we know the potential, now we will use equation 1 to find the work done. So the work done from P to Q is the charge which you move into potential at Q minus potential at P. The charge which you are moving is how much? Minus 2 nanocoulomb. So minus 2 into 10 power minus 9. These are all scalar quantities. If it is negative, you have to write negative. Don't say, sir, I'll write, you know, magnitude minus sign will mean the direction like that. So this is work done. It can be positive, it can be negative. So if it is negative, mention it is negative. Okay. So Q naught is the charge which we are moving, which they get negative. Potential at Q. Potential at Q, how much we got? Potential at Q? 18. Potential at P, how much we got? 24. And I can take 10 to the power 8 as common. Right, students? Okay. So minus 2, and this 18 minus 24 will be how much? Minus 6. Yes or no? So this will be minus 2 into minus 6 will be plus 12 into 10 power minus 9, 10 power 8 will be 10 power minus 1. So 1.2 joules. So this much positive work has to be done to take this Q naught charge, which was minus 2 nanocoulomb, from point P to point Q. Okay, via whichever path, it doesn't matter. If the initial point and final point, if you know, you can calculate the work done. Okay, students? Fine. Let us see question number 2 now. So please remember, electrostatic force is a conservative force. So work done against the electrostatic force, if you want to move the charges slowly, will not depend on the path. It only depends on the initial position and the final position. Let us see now question number 2. ABCD is a square of side 0.2 meter. So ABCD is a square of side 0.2 meter. Charges of 2 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb. So here one charge is kept, 2 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb. 4 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb. 4 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb and 8 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb are placed at the corners A, B, C. Calculate the work required to transfer a charge. So this is the charge which they are going to move. So this is not your source charge. So don't keep it somewhere in the diagram. This is your source charge. And the source charge is 2 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb from D, which is the other corner, to the center of the square, to the center O of the square. Center will be wherever the diagonals intersect. So this point O. So basically we are moving this Q naught charge from here to here like this. Okay, so first what we will do, now you have understood, I think. Now we have to find potential at D first. So potential at D. Who will produce potential at D? Source charges. How many source charges are there? 3 source charges. So let us write the formula first. Okay, in board exams you should write formula. Directly if you do, you will not get full marks. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught charge at A divided by distance between charge and point, which is AB, plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, let me take common, this one at least, okay, I know this will be common, right, charge at B divided by BD, right, charge at B divided by this distance from charge to point, plus charge at C divided by CB. So this is the total potential at point D. Before we continue, let us calculate. Okay, side of the square they should give. No, what is the side of the square according to the question is 0.2 meter. So this is 0.2 meter, this is 0.2 meter. What will be diagonal? DD. So BD from Pythagoras theorem will be root of this square plus this square. So 0.2 square plus 0.2 square, which will be root 2 into 0.2 centimeter or meter, meter they put. Okay, so BD we will need, so I have calculated BD here. Okay, so let us substitute the values. This is constant, 9 into 10 to the power 9. Charge at A is 2 divided by AD. This AD is 0.2, so 0.2 plus charge at B is 4 divided by BD, BD is root 2 into 0.2, correct na? Plus charge at C, 8 divided by CD is also 0.2. Now what I have missed, all these charges are 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb C. So I will write that in the common, 10 to the power minus 9. Here I mean. Okay. So then you can see this will be this 10 to the power 9 and 10 to the power minus 9 will cancel. So this will be 9. This is 20 divided by 0.2. Yes or no? Sorry, 20 divided by 2 I can write. So this is 10 plus this is 40 divided by 2, right? 0.2, I hope you know, no? You can write 2 by 10 also. So 10 will go up. So 40 divided by 2 will be 20, but this root 2 is also there. Plus this 8 divided by 0.2 means 80 by 2, which is 40 also. So now this you can use calculator because by root 2 is also there. So use calculator and check whether the answer which I got is right or wrong. Okay, so I got 577.298 volt. So this is the potential at which point D. Now let us do potential at the other point, which from where to where I have to take this Q naught charge, from D to O. So I want now potential at O. So let me just do it here only, potential at O. So now I have to write who will produce potential at O, the three charges. So this distance will be your AO. AO. This will be BO. This will be CO. Right? Now this value will be same, charges are same, only this distance is different. So let us calculate AO, BO and CO. So look carefully here. AO must be same as BO, must be same as CO. Right? This distance, this distance, this distance. And it is nothing but half of this distance is half of diagonal. Diagonal was root 2 into 0.1 meter. Yes or no, students? Right? Diagonal was, see here, diagonal we have done already. BD we have done already. So this will be 0.1 by root 2 meter. Okay, so everywhere I will get 0.1 root 2 I can take up, 0.1 root 2 I can take up, 0.1 root 2 I can take up, right? Because AO, BO, CO, all of them are 0.1 by root 2. Correct, no, students? Okay. Again, you can use calculator here. You can write this as 20, this is 40, this is 80, no? Once you divide by 0.1. So if I do that, this will be 20. This will be how much? 40. And this will be how much? 80. And root 2 I can take common outside. Root 2 value is 1.414. So please use calculator so that you can check whether my answer is right or wrong. So this will be potential at O. So finally, if you do the calculation, you should get potential at O, you should get 891.089 volt. So once I found potential at this point and this point, question was work done to bring Q naught charge from where to where, D to O. Tell me the formula. The charge which you move, I am writing Q naught, VO minus VD. So Q naught value is 2 into 10 power minus 9. VO value is 891.089 minus VD. VD I have done before, right? VD before I have done 578. Okay, let me just slightly adjust this. 298. Okay, so this calculation again you have to do yourself. So you will get finally 6.3 approximately into 10 to the power minus 9 joules. Okay. Not 6.3. You will get 6.3 to 7.6 into 10 power minus 9 joules. So that would be the answer. So again, calculation part you should not worry. You are allowed calculator in board exams. Okay. However, the formulas and how to substitute, how to do this simple calculation before you start using calculator, that I am showing to you very clearly. Okay. Let us see question number 3 now. So question number 3, it says ABC is a right angle triangle where AB and BC are 25 cm and 60 cm. So ABC is a right angle triangle. AB distance, AB side and BC side are 25 cm and 60 cm. So let us draw a right angle triangle. So this is AB. And this is BC. BC is the longer one according to the question they told. So AB is given as 25 cm and BC is given as 60 cm. Now listen carefully. A metal sphere of 2 cm radius. A metal sphere of 2 cm radius. So 2 cm is very small compared to these two, right? So a very small sphere is kept at B. This is a metal sphere, let me mention, okay? Metal sphere. Okay. And listen carefully, students. Radius, 2 cm radius. So radius of the metal sphere is 2 cm. This is radius of metal sphere. So this radius is 2 cm and it has been charged to a potential of 9 into 10 power 5 volt. So the potential of the sphere they have given. Be careful, okay, not of some particular point, but potential of the sphere means on the surface of the sphere. So potential of the sphere is given as 9 into 10 to the power 5 volt. So this is at surface of the sphere. At surface of sphere. So this is not potential here, 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 anywhere. This is potential of the sphere. So the sphere has been charged. Okay, that's why it will have some potential. Already we have seen potential due to sphere on the surface. We have seen the formula. Okay. So this is the potential of the sphere. Okay, be very careful. Now they are asking, find the amount of work done in carrying a positive charge 2 microcoulomb. So the charge which we are moving, I am writing Q naught. So how much charge we are moving? 2 microcoulomb. From where to where? From C to A. So from C to A means, in diagram if I try to show, this way we are trying to move the charge. So what we need to do, students, we need to calculate potential at C and potential at A. Job is done, finished. Because once we know potential here and potential here, we can calculate the work done to move any charge. But till now, to find potential, what we need? Source charge. Who is the source charge here? Charge, they have not mentioned anywhere. Read anywhere. There is no charge mentioned. But they have given you potential of the sphere. And when will a sphere have potential on the surface if the sphere has been charged? So the sphere must be having some charge which I am writing as Q. So first we should calculate this charge. Okay. So let Q be charge on the sphere, which is at which point they told P. Since it is a small sphere, you can treat it like, you know, a very small sphere and it is near to point B. It is almost at B only, we can say, because it is very small. Okay, then what is the potential at the surface of a sphere? Potential at the surface of the sphere was, please remember, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught charge on the sphere divided by what we used to write here. Think and tell me quickly, radius of the sphere. Radius of the sphere. Don't take point outside, don't take point inside. Because they told it has been charged, the sphere has been charged to some potential. So if I say Pankaj sir has this much potential, it means some point on my surface. So this is the potential on the surface of the sphere. Okay, students. Now this was given to you, 9 × 10⁵. So don't do the mistake, which many students think that oh this is the potential at this point like that. No, this is potential of the sphere. They mentioned very clearly. And this is how much, 9 × 10⁹. Charge of the sphere we don't know. That is what we are trying to find. And radius of the sphere was how much? Radius was 2 cm. 2 × 10⁻²⁰. Convert in SI units. So 9 will cancel, cross multiply. So charge will be 2 will come here. 10⁻²⁰ will also come. 10⁵ is already there. Then if you divide by 10⁹. So charge on the sphere is 2 × 10⁻²⁵ + 5 will be +3. And 9 will go up, -9. So it will be -6 coulomb. So this is the first thing we should do. So first find the charge of the sphere. Once we have known, okay, now we can write here charge is 2 × 10⁻⁶. So now we know our source charge. So now the problem is like old problem, the first problem. So now what we should do? Find potential at C due to the source charge. Then find potential at A due to the source charge. Okay, so let us do that. So what will be the potential at C? I can treat this as a point charge located at B because they said small. So potential at C, VC. What will be the formula? 1/4πε₀. Source charge is Q. Distance between source charge and observation point is VC. This is what we used to write as R, small r. Then you substitute 9 × 10⁹. Source charge is 2 × 10⁻⁶. BC, be careful, BC was given 60 cm. So 60 cm means 10⁻². Right? Okay. So this will be 2 3s are here. 3 1s are, 3 3s are, right? So it will be 3 × 9 − 6 + 3. 10, this is 10⁻², this is 10, so it will be −1 will go up +1, so it will be 4. So 10⁴ volt. So this is the potential at C. Let us now ask potential at A, because we are moving the charge from C to A, na? So potential at A will be, write the formula first. Okay, so this time I will substitute directly. So this value will be what? 9 × 10⁹. In exam, please write formula first, okay? Source charge is how much? 2 × 10⁻⁶. And what distance I should use? Distance between source charge and point is this distance. This is given 25 cm. So this will be 25 × 10⁻². In meter, you have to convert, okay? So if you do this calculation, then potential at C, potential at C we have done, potential at A will come 7.2 × 10⁴ volt. Okay, please use calculator if you wish. 7.2 × 10⁴ volt. Fine, students. So we have found potentials at both the points. So now finally we have to calculate the work done. So work done to bring Q0 charge. From where to where they told? From C to A, W. From C to A will be Q0, the charge which you move, into VA − VC. That order you have to be very careful, okay? The charge which you are moving is 2 microcoulombs. So I can write 2 × 10⁻⁶. Potential at A, I got 7.2. Minus potential at C, I got 3. And here also 10⁴, here also 10⁴, so I can take common. Okay, students, so you simplify this part, you will get 8.4 × 10⁻², joules. Okay, because this will be 4.2, na? This will be 4.2 × 2 will be 8.4. So this is how simple Okay, we can do it very easily in a very simple way. So these three problems were all based on finding work done to move some charge from point A to point B. But that will only happen if point A and point B already have some potential. And who will produce potential at point A and point B? Some source charges. Question number 4, now you see, this is the second type. I told you two types of problems there will be in this session. So question number 4, you see, calculate work done to dissociate. I will explain the meaning, don't worry. Work done to dissociate the system of three charges placed on the vertices of a triangle as shown in the figure. So they have given you a figure which is of an equilateral triangle. The side of the triangle is 10 cm each side, and the charges kept are Q here, minus 4Q here and Q here, and they have given Q value is 10 power minus 6 coulomb. Okay, we have to find the energy work done to dissociate this system. Dissociate means to take this charge, all to infinity. That is the meaning when we say dissociate a molecule. So when you want to dissociate a molecule, all the atoms should be removed so far that they don't come back to each other. And that will only happen when you take them to infinity. Now, students, you may be thinking, sir, really we should take them to infinity? No, because the distance between atoms in a molecule will be how much? Some 1 angstrom like that. So if you take them to 2 cm also, that will be like infinity. See, infinity in physics means a number very large compared to the numbers which are involved in the problem. So if you are dealing with meters and, you know, if you are dealing with meters and kilometers, then light year can be taken as infinity. But if you are dealing with 1 angstrom, 2 angstrom, then you can take 1 meter also as infinity. Okay. Anyways, so the point here is to find the work done to dissociate this system. Dissociate means all of them should be taken to infinity. All of them should be taken to infinity. So what we will do? Here we will calculate the initial potential energy of the system. Ui. So what will be the initial potential energy of the system? You can see this is a system of three charges. So how many pairs are there? Three pairs. One pair, two pair, three pair. So formula was 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1, Q2. First pair is Q divided by distance between them. Let us say the side is R. This side is R, let us say. So this will be also R. This will be also R. Right? Okay, then second pair is this, Q and minus 4Q, Q minus 4Q. Remember, if it is negative, you have to write negative. Distance is again R. Then you write potential energy of the third pair, this pair. That pair will be also Q minus 4Q divided by R. So that is the potential energy of this system, right? For each pair, you write the formula for potential energy between two charges, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R. Today itself I have derived. So this will be how much? 9 into 10 power 9. Q into Q is common everywhere. I can take it common, Q square. R is common everywhere. What is left? 1 here, minus 4 here, minus 4 here. Right? Q square I took common, R I took common. So this would be 9 into 10 power 9. Value of Q was given 10 power minus 6, so square it, 10 power minus 12. Distance R between the charges is 10 centimeters, so 10 into 10 power minus 2 meter, and this will be minus 8, 1 will be minus 7. So this will be 9 minus 7 will be minus 63 into 10 power. 9 minus 12 will be minus 3, yes or no? And here minus 1 will be there, that will go up plus 1. So 10 power minus 2 joules. So this is the potential energy of the system initially. Okay, students, 63 into 10 power minus 2 joules. Now, final potential energy. final potential energy. Since you want to dissociate, final potential energy means when each distance is infinity. That way you can understand. Or best way to write is, directly you can write 0, since at infinity potential energy is taken to be 0. Yes or no? So since potential energy at infinity is 0, once you dissociate them, final potential energy will be 0. So work done by the external agency. How to calculate? Now don't write Q into Q naught into VB minus VA. We are not bringing a charge from one point to another point. We are changing the configuration of the system. So right now the system looks like this. After some time, all of them should be at infinity. Okay, so it will be change in potential energy. Matlab, U final minus U initial. U final is 0, U initial is minus. Minus minus will be plus. So 63 into 10 power minus 2 joules. So whatever is the negative initial energy, that much positive work you have to do in order to dissociate this system. Okay, students. Let's see the last question of this numerical exercise. 3 point charges, 1 coulomb, 2 coulomb and 3 coulomb. There are 3 point charges, are placed at the corners of an equilateral triangle of side 1 meter. Okay, so let me first drop the board so that we get space to solve the last problem. So there are 3 charges in an equilateral triangle, 1 coulomb, 2 coulomb, 3 coulomb, distance is 1 meter. Okay, now listen carefully what they are saying. There is another smaller equilateral triangle of side 0.5 meter as shown. So there is another smaller equilateral triangle of side 0.5 meter inside the action. This is 0.5 meter. Find the work required to move the charges to the corners of the smaller equilateral triangle. So basically what they are saying is, initial system will look like this. Initial system. Then final system should look like this. It should be a small triangle. Here 1 coulomb. Here 2 coulomb, here 3 coulomb, and this is 0.5 meter. Understood or not? So this is your final system. So what is the work done? Again, they are not asking you to bring a charge from one point to another point. They are simply changing the configuration of the charges and they are asking you how much work will be done. So let us calculate initial potential energy. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q1, Q2, first pair. 1 coulomb, 2 coulomb divided by distance between them is 1, plus second pair, 1 coulomb, 3 coulomb, distance between them is 1, plus 2 coulomb, 3 coulomb, distance between them is 1. Okay, so this will be 9 into 10 power 9, 2 plus 3 plus 6, right students? So this will be 3 plus 6, 9. 11, 11 into 9 is 99 into 10 power 9 joules. That is the initial potential energy of the system. Initial potential energy of system. Now calculate final potential energy of the system once the configuration has changed. So final will be what? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 into 2. Charges are same, but distance has become now smaller. So the side was 1 meter, now it is 0.5 meter. So 0.5 plus 1 into 3 by 0.5 plus 2 into 3 divided by 0.5. It is useless to do calculation actually, because everywhere you are dividing by 0.5. That is like saying everywhere you are dividing by half. That means multiplying by 2. So it will basically 2 into this. So it will be 2 into 99 into 10 power 9 joules. Okay, you can check yourself. If you don't believe me, put the value of this, calculate this, you will get this much only. So the work done. So to work done will be equal to change in potential energy, U final minus U initial. So 2 into 99 minus 99 will be 99 into 10 power 9 joules. Okay, let me just check once for, yeah, so it is correct. Okay, so this is how students, these two kinds of problems are very common. So if they don't ask derivations from this chapter, they may ask numericals like this, especially the ones where we bring the charge from one point to another point. Okay, so please practice them nicely. Home exercises you solve, then confidence will come. And one more last thing, when I do numericals, don't think they are important only for board. Okay, I can change the numbers and make it simple for calculation, and then I can ask the same questions in entrance also. So when I do entrance concepts, when I put hashtag, that is important only for entrance. But when I do anything else, board or hashtag, all are important for entrance exams. Okay, students. So thank you. Have a nice day.